Hello, fellow gardeners. Welcome back. We're back in now answering questions, giving you some answers on some questions that some of them have concern. And I want to make a comment first before we start answering questions. Now, yes, we started letting them put some ads on our videos. And the reason we did that, because there was quite a bit of money there that was going to come in that we could use on our scholarship fund. So if an ad comes on, I don't have any idea what kind of ads are being put on. I don't have any choice over those ads. So if an ad comes on that you're not interested in or you don't like the looks of, just punch it off and let's go on with the video, because I don't have any control over that. But those of you that you can look at it and might glean a little something from it or something or other, or willing to listen to it, we do get a little bit of money for that for our scholarship fund. So we're trying to build this scholarship fund as much as we can, and we couldn't see any need of letting that go by. Okay, that's enough for that. Some of them ask about up there in that 30 below zero weather, what could you do about keeping your root system from freezing in those buckets, even in the garage or in a high tunnel that you wasn't heating? My camera crew mentioned this, said, what if you've got you a heating pad that you can buy at chain stores or something? I know you can, you know, in these gardening magazines, you can get these heat mats that you lay your flats on that will heat your soil to germinate your seed. You know, you could either buy one of those and lay it you could lay a piece of something down to kind of plywood or something, and then lay that heating pad on that, heating mat, and then set your barrel on top of that. I think I would put some little boards along on each side or something to hold it up off that mat and not really set it right on it. I don't know whether the pressure on it would make it short out worse or anything, but I'm not suggesting you do this, but some of you is really worried about your roots in your tubs, putting them in the garage and still letting them freeze. You could sure keep it warm that away a little bit. Just wrap a blanket around it or anything like that would help. But anyway, we don't have that problem here. You know, we get down to 15 or 20 degrees, but we don't ever get below zero. And I feel for you folks up north where you do. Okay, now then, you know, you could go in there and set up your step ladder in between a couple of these trees or these wicking tubs that you've got some kind of perennial or some kind of plant that's gonna, like a fruit tree or a fig or grapevines, something like that that's gonna put out next spring. You could set up your step ladder in between them, or maybe two or three step ladders, and then lay your plastic up over your step ladders and make you a tent over those barrels or those tubs that you've got sitting in that garage. That's just an idea you might want to try for a makeshift little high tunnel in there. And, you know, there's different variations of growing ways in each area. In other words, what works down here in Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma, and north Texas, it's going to get hot here. We use some varieties that we'll try to go on into the summer, like Sunmaster or Heat Wave on tomato plants. Just any of those things that are kind of bred to take the heat. Whereas if you're up north, you know, you could in maybe Alaska or Canada or the northern states that are bordering Canada, maybe you'd use some short day tomato like they use in Russia, where they don't have to have real hot weather to produce tomatoes. There's some Russian varieties. And y'all get these catalogs and look at your tomatoes in the wintertime while you've got time sitting in there. You're bored, too cold to go outside and garden. Well, get your gardening magazines or your seed catalogs and go to finding the seeds that you want, and just think of where you are. If you're in a sunny part in the southern part of the states, or if you're up north, you got to use a short variety, Russian variety or something like that, then order some of those and try them. And then there's heirlooms I know you can grow. You know, that's an heirloom is a variety that's years and years ago that they haven't bred up, haven't changed it. It's still an old ugly tomato. It's got a wonderful flavor. It just doesn't have a pretty shape. And so a lot of people don't like those. And so Then there's also the open pollinated. That's just an old variety like Sioux or Marglobe or Earliana, Homestead. Those are just open pollinated varieties. They grow that one variety, let's say Homesteads, and they'll grow a patch of Homesteads and nothing else to cross with it, and then they'll harvest those seeds after those tomatoes get completely ripe, and they'll get those seeds out of those tomatoes that are mature, and that's what they sell for open pollinated. Now then there's also hybrid tomatoes, which they will cross two different tomatoes and make a variety come out of that, and then they'll sell that the next year as a hybrid that's a cross between two different varieties. Sometimes they're good, sometimes they're not, but they usually don't have as good a flavor as some of your open pollinated or your heirlooms. But anyway, everybody has to kind of decide what varieties you're going to use in your area. It would be senseless to get something like a Heat Wave or a Sun Master or a Sun Leaper and take it and grow it up there in the edge of Canada where they barely get enough sun, where they barely get enough heat. That's not what you need. You need something that's short day, early girl, early doll, or some of those Russian varieties, and try some of them up that way. Anyway, do a little thinking on your own and decide what you need to use. Okay, let's see what else we need to answer about. Asking how do we get that air into those wicking tubs? Well, let me tell you, you don't have to really worry about it, because wherever there's no soil or no water, guess what? It's going to fill with air. It's not going to be a vacuum there like you might think. There will be air anywhere you don't have a solid. So I tried to draw a little picture. This is kind of a picture of your wicking tub. You see your milk jugs or water jugs sitting in there. You've punched holes in the bottom and top, and you've got water sitting up to this. Here's your drain hole here, and it's going to set up to that 5-inch level right there. Now, anything below that's going to be full of water. Anything above that will be full of air or soil. It's right in here. This is all soil down in between them cracks. That's going to be soil. There's some air space in between that soil. And there's air space in this hollow jug that's going to go in them holes, I promise you. There's not going to be a vacuum inside of that. If you draw the vacuum on it, it just collapses those jugs. But you're not drawing a vacuum. It's got air. It can get to it from several different ways. It can come down through this soil. It can come in that hole, the top part of that hole, and go in here and fill these up. So don't worry about your air. It's going to be in there. Yes, what you ought to worry about is not putting too heavy a soil down in here that it wicks up too much water, or having too big a hole full of soil to wick up too much water. Now, some people ask me, can they use a cheaper potting soil down in these cracks to suck up water? Yes, you can. Go get you something that's cheap. Stick in there. Don't get something that's real, real fine, because if you do, they will just suck up water and there's no air getting in with it. And if too much water up there can drown your plant. So get a looser mix to put down in there. At the same time, you can get it too coarse to where it wouldn't wick. It would stay full of air and your moisture can't go up through it. So it's got a happy medium you got to get to. But if you don't want to use regular potting soil down through there that you buy, then get you a cheaper mix and try that in the bottom. Then put your good mix up on top. And then also talking for this, or rounding this up here, if you'll just use that cheaper mix up there or some compost, this don't have to be your good mix up here on top around your plants. As long as you get your plant planted deep through that plastic, you can use a coarse mix up here for a mulch, and that'll keep your temperature down on your tomato plants. Okay, if you like these videos, ring the bell, punch the button, subscribe, and we'll make you another video. Thank you. Have a good day.